Unsolved mysteries like Bigfoot and the Loch Ness Monster continue to entice the minds of the imaginative, yet our planet is inherently bizarre, as Earth is not just any normal world. Weird natural phenomena already proven to exist on Earth are certainly more than sufficiently bizarre to astonish us. And in the video today, we're going to be talking about some true facts that will increase your appreciation of this bizarre and sometimes rather mystical but entirely scientifically explainable world in which we all exist. And just before we get started, I will say there are only 8 entries in this video. Sometimes we just cap it at 8. That's where we go. Starting with the Blue Mountains eucalyptus clouds. Known as a favored food of koalas, eucalyptus trees are a classic feature of the Australian landscape and a symbol of nature down under. Yet few might stop to consider whether eucalyptus trees could contribute to air pollution through their natural release of strong aromatic compounds. The concept of a cloud is familiar. Water vapor or crystals at different concentrations produce the wide variety of forms and colors, including white, light gray, or dark gray. But a remarkable place in Australia offers a much more unusual and ghostly form of cloud activity that has a remarkably biological origin. The blue haze over the Blue Mountains of Australia, which are named for the phenomena, is attributed to volatile organic compounds released by the trees, including potentially harmful isoprene. Because of the phenomena of the haze being formed as a result of eucalyptus tree-derived essential oils, research is being conducted on approaches to model air quality in areas of Australia hosting eucalyptus, with close attention being paid to isoprene emissions from the eucalyptus trees and possible impacts to air quality and human health. The emissions are termed BVOX, or biogenic volatile organic compounds. Southeastern Australia, a region including but not limited to the famed Blue Mountains, is an epicenter for the release of BVOX with their high eucalyptus concentrations. Tektite formation. Scientists can classify most hard objects in our world as simply being rocks, minerals, native elements, fossils, or even meteorites. But a certain type of natural object presents a greater challenge to the inquiring minds of researchers. At different sites around the globe, mysterious glassy objects can be found lying on the ground among normal materials. Named tektites, from a Greek word for melted or molten, the strange, often shiny silica-rich objects are made up of glass of natural origin that has been the subject of a great deal of scientific speculation. Now, generally thought to consist of glass formed by the collisions of meteorites and the Earth's surface at hypervelocity speeds, tektites were first described in ancient China by the Tang Dynasty writer Liu Sun in 900 BC. Since then, tektite discoveries all around the world have continued to puzzle and fascinate the scientists who study them. Considered to be formed by the sheer heat and pressure of meteorite impacts and their interactions with the ground where they hit, tektites show a strewn-about pattern, yet share composition characteristics with the portions of the Earth's surface where they were found. Specific strewn fields where tektites can be found include Australasia, Central Europe, Ivory Coast, and North America. Ball lightning. While commonly referenced, ball lightning remains the subject of controversy as a mysterious and potentially hazardous natural phenomenon. Most frequently encountered during storms with regular lightning, ball lightning has many unusual characteristics that have been reported, including smells and hissing sounds. Ball lightning appears as small to medium-sized glowing spheres that may move about in an erratic manner, potentially causing damage and even injury. A researcher called H.C. Wu, working out of Zhejiang University in Hangzhou, China, has put forward microwave bubbles as an explanation for the bizarre phenomenon known as ball lightning. While the true cause and formation methods of ball lightning remain a matter of continued investigation and scientific curiosity, one of the challenges in studying ball lightning arises through the difficulty in studying the phenomena. While widely reported, ball lightning is fleeting in its lifespan, and a means of creating true ball lightning in a lab has not yet been found. Stranger theories about ball lightning have included speculation that it arises from plasma or even small black holes. Interestingly, ball lightning has been reported to go through glass windows, sometimes even leaving holes or appearing inside of an airplane mid-flight. Balls may range in size from less than an inch to over 8 feet in diameter. Animal rain. You might wish for something other than a rainy day, but mere H2O rain might be welcomed with open arms in lieu of the much more unsettling alternative of animal rain. The expression "raining cats and dogs" is not so far from the truth as it might seem. From time to time around the globe, creatures such as frogs, fish, and invertebrates have rained down from the sky, perplexing viewers and just frankly grossing them out. Meteorological phenomenon with a sucking action is apparently to blame here. In many natural environments, high concentrations of certain animals occur, such as spawning, schooling, or migrating fish, or huge gatherings of amphibians, such as frogs. When a storm involving high winds, such as a tornado or a waterspout, gathers momentum, it could logically strike an area home to large numbers of small creatures vulnerable to being sucked up into the vortex. It is believed that quantities of fish, frogs, and other creatures hurled down from the sky were recently picked up by a tornado or a waterspout and then released as the lifting force of the storm weakened. The phenomenon has been considered for a long time, as there are even ancient accounts of creatures falling from the sky. And we know what you're thinking here, and you're absolutely right. Yes, Sharknado is a lot closer to being scientifically feasible than we ever could have guessed. Halos of the sun and moon. Rainbows are familiar as the result of the sun shining through raindrops of water with prismatic effect. Yet a lesser known effect is responsible for the mysterious looking halos seen forming around the sun, or the ghostly versions that appear around the moon. In the higher parts of Earth's atmosphere, water is represented in the form of tiny, widely scattered ice crystals. At certain times, these ice crystals may be abundant in concurrence with bright sunlight and moonlight at a given time of day or night, with a minimum of cloud cover obscuring the view from the Earth's surface. The result is the formation of halos from the sunlight, or sunlight reflected as moonlight, that refract through the ice crystals in the Earth's atmosphere. The halos may cause the sun to look like the small, glowing center of a much larger celestial object, maybe perhaps even a supernova if you're sci-fi inclined. The moon, in contrast, may take on an exceptionally mystical look, with a field of moonlight much larger and more varied than usual. While the visually arresting events may seem to signify something of great cosmic significance, nothing has really changed except for some ice in the sky. Technicolor lakes. We're used to water looking bluish, or even brown or light green if there's a lot of algae, but certain water bodies around the world boast colors so extreme that they look like an imaginative child took a few boxes of crayons and totally reimagined the usual order of the natural world. Lake Hylia is one of the most striking examples of watercolor craziness in nature. Located on Middle Island in Australia, the lake is separated from the ocean by an exceedingly narrow strip of low-lying land. The bright pink coloration of the lake recalls the feathers of a flamingo, contrasting with a lawn, presenting a mystery as to whether it's of biological or mineralogical origin. But it is natural, and it's not harmful to humans. Kawaijin Lake in Indonesia, by contrast, is an opaque blue color far beyond the natural bluish look of other water bodies. This is because of the minerals in its water. The location of this lake is a surprise, too. It's at the top of a volcano. The lake is the highest acidity lake on the planet, with potentially lethal risks due to volcanic and associated geothermal activity. Further toxic gases are released at dangerous thresholds. Tornadoes. Wildfires might be terrifying, and tornadoes may be dangerous, but a combination of these disasters sounds like the stuff of scary science fiction. Yet what might be termed a firenado is totally real. The bizarre phenomenon occurs as tornado activity meets forest fires. Alternatively, tornado formation can be provoked by the existence of a forest fire with its variations in heat and air movement patterns. Once a fire tornado is started, they can go on for a long time and cause a great degree of devastation. One example would be one that was part of the Carr Fire close to Redding in Northern California, which claimed several lives, including the life of a firefighter who was swallowed by the firenado. The hot winds were so severe here that a metal pipe ended up wrapped around a tree. Firenados consist of swirling eddies brought about by the heat of an existing fire. The rotating hot mass gets a life of its own as it pulls in hot gases and becomes a swirling column, a tube, and a funnel of flame. The firenado can set fire to whatever it touches as it travels, and also toss burning objects aside, spreading the fire even further. Flammable methane ice. The concept of explosive or otherwise flammable icy environments might seem ludicrous to many. Explosions are by nature not wet or cold, but extremely hot and dry. Cold, wet environments seem simply antithetical to a fiery and hellish explosion. But while the concept of hell freezing over is used to imply never, a frozen lake can quickly produce patches of fiery fury under certain scientifically explainable circumstances, namely methane accumulation. To avoid a blast of flames from the ice, you might want to hold off a moment on discarding that match or cigar from the side of a boat in icy waters in certain northern lakes. Accumulation of organic rotting matter is inherent in stagnant waters, and if you combine this with cold weather and the resultant ice sheet formation, this can trap large quantities of methane. The flick of a lighter close to a hole in the ice, even just 2 to 3 inches wide, can cause a mushroom cloud of fire over 5 feet tall. Upward lightning. Ball lightning is bizarre enough, but few people are aware that lightning bolts do not always come down from the sky. We might take it for granted that just as what goes up must come down, lightning descends rapidly from the sky to strike the earth. But not always. An exceptionally weird form of lightning exists that means you could be struck by lightning coming from the ground while theoretically in the air. Upward lightning consists of bolts that shoot eerily from terrestrial surfaces and structures and up into the sky. Dendritic or tree-like in pattern, the bolts reach towards the skies, completely confusing the unprepared viewer of the strange phenomenon. The reason for the phenomenon is centered on differences in electrical charge, but the explanation does not make the perplexing sight of lightning striking at the sky from a terrestrial object any less disconcerting. American atmospheric scientist Tom A. Warner has used high-speed cameras to document these lightning bolts. The bolts resemble typical lightning in shape, just turned upside down. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. And don't forget to subscribe. We've got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. And if you're looking for something else to watch, why not subscribe to one of my other channels called Biographics? You'll find a link to that on the screen now. And as always, thank you for watching.